Hello friends, I am Professor Mane. Today I will give you the brief introduction about two cavity Klystron amplifier. This topic is there in a subject microwave radar engineering, which is there in the third year diploma semester 5th. Now what is microwave? A signal whose frequency lies, normally we say that a signal whose frequency lies in the range of gigahertz is known as microwave frequency signal. The moment we use microwave frequency signal, then whatever the conventional amplifiers which we use in our basic electronics are useless. For example, BJT common emitter amplifier or op-amp, these circuits cannot amplify microwave frequency signal. Hence, to generate and to amplify microwave frequency signal, we use separate special types of devices, like two cavity Klystron is used to amplify the microwave frequency signal. Reflex Klystron is used to generate the microwave frequency signal. Magnetron is used to generate the microwave frequency signal. So today I will give you the brief introduction about two cavity Klystron amplifier, which is used to amplify the weak microwave signal. The two cavity Klystron amplifier is basically a vacuum tube amplifier. So this is the construction of a two cavity Klystron amplifier. It consists of an anode, it consists of a cathode. The cathode is cylindrical in shape. The outer body of the cathode is coated with the barium oxide, and inside the cathode we have the coil, and to this coil we apply 6.3 volt AC supply. Now when we apply 6.3 volt AC supply, then barium oxide heats up and it produces the large number of electrons. We apply external DC voltage between anode and cathode such that anode is positive with respect to cathode. Normally the value of DC voltage is in the range of 250 volt to 500 volt DC. Apart from this, in the input side we have a cavity known as buncher cavity. So this is known as buncher cavity, in which the circular shape behaves like an inductor and this rectangular space behaves like a capacitor. So input side we have buncher cavity, on the output side we have catcher cavity. Let us study how does these two cavity Klystron amplifier amplifies the microwave frequency signal. As I told you that cathode is used to generate large number of electrons, and we apply the high positive voltage to the anode. So this high positive voltage applied to the anode will attract the electrons from the cathode. So between anode and cathode there will be an electron beam. We want this electron beam to be a sharp electron beam, for which we need a focusing, and hence we use focusing electrode. We apply external DC voltages, not shown in the diagram. We apply external DC voltages to the focusing electrode so that we get a sharp electron beam. The input microwave signal which I want to amplify is applied to this small conductor present in the buncher cavity. Now what happens when we apply the weak input signal to this buncher cavity? We apply the signal in electrical form. When we apply the signal to the electrical form, this small conductor behaves like a small antenna and it converts electrical signal into a EMF, electromagnetic field signal, and hence in this puncture cavity, we get EMF, electromagnetic field signal, whose strength is weak. Now this EMF signal is axial, it's in the vertical axis. This EMF signal interacts with the electron beam which is going below it. Now when the EMF signal and the moving electron beam interact with each other, then a special phenomenon takes place known as bunching of electrons. So what happens when the EMF field and the moving electron, they interact with each other, it forms a bunch of electron where lots of electrons comes together and the EMF field interacts in that bunch of electron. And there in the bunch of electron, the moving electron gives their own energy to the EMF signal, because of which the energy of the EMF signal increases. Now this electron bunch will travel from puncture cavity and goes towards the catcher cavity. Now once this electron bunch comes under the catcher cavity, then in this catcher cavity we have a small conductor electrode which again behaves like an antenna. So what happens, now the EMF signal from this electron bunch will be catched by the catcher cavity. So now in the catcher cavity we will get EMF signal, but with increase in the strength. This EMF signal will cut the output conductor, and this output conductor, as per Faraday's law, converts EMF signal into a electrical signal, and at the output we get amplified. At the output we get amplified microwave signal. So this is how two cavity Klystron amplifier used to amplify the weak microwave frequency signal. This particular subject called microwave radar, it is in this we have got the 5 units. Half of the units are based on the microwave technology and half of the units based on radar technology. And here all the topics are dealing with the very high frequency, like a gigahertz frequency. So this entire subject is completely conceptual. It's a quite a bit tough to understand, and hence you need the extra coaching for this particular subject, and you will get this best extra coaching for this particular subject only in Vidyalankar classes. So I will request all the third year diploma students, please go to the nearby Vidyalankar center and join the classes for this particular subject, because if you join the Vidyalankar class, then you can ensure the very good marks in your final year diploma. So student, be sure with Vidyalankar. Thank you.